Sup guys, what we look at today is Game Boy Micro. No, this is Waveshare GPM280, which has an identical looking to Nintendo GBM. From the front side, the form factor is totally copy of Game Boy Micro. Whilst compared to the original GBM, Waveshare GPM seems more like a playable handheld. It's not the small size of GBM. It has a classic FC controller look. The glass panel feels good and I like the back of the shell, which painted with coating that some glitters. But it's easy to get scratches, so be careful with that. The retro machine has two sets of airflow vents. Through the vents, it pastes with some graphite flakes for lowering the temperature. The D-pad and face buttons are similar to the ones of GBM. I'm a fan of the D-pad of the original GBM. It feels much better than GBA. Waveshare GPM did a little change with that. The D-pad is capable of sliding. Action buttons still have enough travel and are responsive. Now we have the LR triggers, a charging port. Below the console, we got a power switch. One thing you need to be careful about is, do remember to push the power button aside after shut down the system. And we have the TF card slot and the audio jack. The volume rocker is on the right side. This GPM280 is fairly lightweight. It's not bad from its build quality so far. It's worth to be mentioned that GPM powered by Raspberry Pi Compute Module 3 Plus Lite. This is a console that plays some old systems like GBA, GBC, NS, and NES. It can also run some simple PSP games. GPM has 1500 mAh battery with 2 hours of playtime. It takes 1 hour to be fully charged based on my test. Okay, let's power on the device and see how it works. The machine includes a charging indicator on the select and start button, so you can supervise battery power at any time. Now it is blue because I've been playing for a while. Green color indicates fully charged. You need to charge the device when the indicator gets red. GPM is based on the red Cobox user interface. This system gets better performance on emulation. If you are a fan of RetroPi, you can access the Waveshare website to get the RetroPi image file to do the refresh by yourself. Moving to the display is a 2.8-inch IPS panel, which is larger than the GBM's 2-inch screen. I don't think it's enough, but thanks to a resolution of 640 by 480, it does have great effects in terms of view angle. It has vibrant colors, but I just feel it's a little bit wasteful for a 2.8-inch IPS screen. The IMG59U has ROMs preloaded, so I can jump right into the games. It includes two games in the PSP library. Let's get started from here. The games like Metal Slug X runs flawlessly. If you want to adjust the backlit, just hold the L trigger and press the volume rocker to change the brightness. Hadouken! 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 The back of the case seems weakened. It's not rigid in my palm. I'm a fan of the action button and the D-pad, especially the D-pad. It feels comfortable and the height is appropriate, but there's a problem, it's easy to get stuck. The slideable D-pad helps a lot in racing and fighting games. I don't need to push very hard. We can update ROMs via Wi-Fi. It's easy. Just toggle the Wi-Fi and input the password. We don't see Wi-Fi connected, but it's okay if the IP address shows on the screen. It may be a bug, who knows. If you still have a problem with the Wi-Fi connection, you need to check the battery power. Now I enter the Chrome, type IP address. We see the record box manager. Just add and delete ROMs at your requirement. Overall, Waveshare GPM is more like a collection for the screen size and the CPU limitation. For many people, they like to get a GPM on eBay instead of a console never heard before. But if you are into it, you can find it on AliExpress.com with a price of $150. I don't think it's cheap. The retro gamers can be roughly divided into two types. Some are satisfied with open source consoles, and some are willing to spend several times the price on more powerful Windows devices. So which type do you belong to? Okay, thanks for watching. Do remember to subscribe to my channel and thumb up.